Allow there to be a gentleness in your approach. And let yourself ease into the moment. Almost like the space around your body and the quiet in the room is like a lullaby, welcoming you. This gentle approach requires no pushing, no knowing spiritual special things. It's like coming to the divine from the ground, from having our feet in the mud. Our toes in the sand. Going to pull out of the mud or the sand to get somewhere or to direct this time, just to see what happens. Can we let a new level of trust arise here? Maybe I don't have to work so hard. Maybe God is good. You can begin today by giving up. This won't be the meditation where that thing you're working on magically heals, or you finally have a deep insight into this thing or that thing, or everything dissolves into a cloud and then it stays that way forever. Let's just give up. Let's let her lead. Maybe we can just admit we don't know what we need. And open. We show up here receptive, ready to be operated on by the divine. The divine doctors don't need our help, our support team, or angels. The beingness itself And if you can't help but direct it or push or lean or long, embrace that. Almost like you would see a person on an operating table starting to tell the doctors what to do. It's like, oh, they're there. It's okay. You can go ahead and do that. And the divine will still show up. Just create a little space there. Like that one's just a little one. Scared, not trusting. Blind to what's here. You might feel the light pouring down from above or emanating or carrying you, holding you from below. And just like a waterfall, it doesn't need our help to flow. It doesn't need us to be good or work hard. We can just be our human self and let the flow come all the way into the most regular parts of ourselves, all the way down on the ground. What if this isn't our mess to clean up? Or our bliss to grab onto? What if it wasn't ours? What if we could just sit here as the mess? Or the bliss, or whatever is here? And let the divine come for us. And let the divine inoculate us. Live our mess, live our life. Love. If there's a gesture that supports your body, your soma, to know that you're an offering, you're offering yourself. You can feel the body climb up on the altar, crawl up on the altar, plop on the altar, help. The body move into a position that helps it know it's an offering. Like if the hands want to open, or the chest wants to come up a little bit, or the head tilt back, or the hands come up. Like the body is used to handing simple things over, or setting your cup down. It's like to really let it embody that, whatever shows up. Maybe you're holding a part of yourself in your hands. Maybe your whole body is the gesture of surrender. It's like, how could we think we know what we need or which way this whole thing's supposed to go? How could we think that? Just an old hallucination, just an old habit. Like, we don't need to be that smart. We can let the divine lead us. Let the divine hold us. Let the divine live our life. Love our life. Be our life. Just keep finding places in the body where you've messed it up or tied it in more knots. And make yourself an offering there. I don't know what to do with this. Here you go. Please help. Come right down into this tangled mess. Help. Of grace are ever blowing. Let us set sail and catch the breeze. The winds of grace are ever blowing. The breeze, the winds of grace are ever blowing. Let us set sail and catch the breeze, the winds of grace. If you have any extra today, you can send it to someone you love, or someone that inspired you, or someone that smiled at you at the coffee shop one day. Make sure that you're receiving as you give, as you let it overflow. Take lots of slurps. Thank you. Have a good day. Thanks for showing up for God and yourself and love and all the things that are the same thing. Take care.